Hey, what's going on, everybody? Paul Tech here, and welcome back to another video. Today, I present you with the unboxing and hands-on of the Humidigi A5 Pro. Now, I did pick this up off of Amazon. I paid $130 for this device. It is globally unlocked. It's going to work with all GSM carriers across the board. It's also rumored to possibly work with Verizon, but I'll definitely have to test that out and let you know in a future video. As you can see, we got a front little sleeve here to the box. We'll go ahead and remove that, and Humidigi branding to the front. And taking a look at the back of the box, as you can see, some specifications there. For the CPU, it is the MT6763, in other words, the Helio P23 processor, which is octa-core, Android 9 Pi on board, 4 gigs of RAM, 32 gigs of ROM. You got a dual nano SIM setup on this, a 4150 milliamp hour battery, 6.3 inch display, 19:9 aspect ratio. So that's going to be 2280x1080 resolution. And when it comes to the cameras, to the back, you're getting three cameras, a 16 megapixel, 8 megapixel, and a 5 megapixel, 16 megapixel front-facing camera, and this is fully unlocked for all GSM carriers with all the LTE bands to the back of the box. So that's pretty much it for the specifications. Let's go ahead and open up the box, cutting the first side, and I'll go ahead and cut the next. There we go. And then I'll go ahead and open up the top portion of the box, and so we got that opened up, and this is basically how it's going to look once you open up your A5 Pro. You get a thank you card here from Humidigi. I'm gonna go ahead and place that off to the side, and then you got the A5 Pro. Let me go ahead and remove it from the box, and as we can see there, it does have a pre-installed screen protector, going over some more specifications to the device, and it also has a pre-installed case which is included, which is pretty nice. All right, let's go ahead and see what else we got here. So you got this little booklet here that does say Link to the World, and to the back of it, it does say Humidigi. Opening up this, you can see you got your SIM removal tool there, and to the inside is going to be your user manual. You also get your wall brick here, and this does charge at 5 volts at 2 amps. Moving on from there, you also get this nicely colored, red colored data cable. Now, unfortunately, this is micro USB data cable. It's not Type-C. I honestly would have wished that Humidigi went with Type-C for this device. And to the star of the show now, the A5 Pro. And like I mentioned earlier, it does come with a pre-installed case on the device. I'm going to go ahead and remove it here. It's actually pretty decent quality as well. It has a nice secure fit to the device, and it is going to provide that protection right out of the box for your A5 Pro. So I just love the fact that Humidigi does include this in the box. That's definitely a nice little bonus you are getting with this device. All right, so moving on from the case, what I want to do next is give you a full tour around the Humidigi A5 Pro, starting with the right-hand side. As you can see, you got your power button there. Right above the power button is going to be your volume rockers. And take a look at the bottom of the device. You got a single down-firing speaker, micro USB charging port, your microphone, as well as your headphone jack. And take a look at the left-hand side. That houses the tray for your dual SIM. You can also input a micro SD card to expand the storage. Up on top, as you can see, the only thing you have there are two antenna lines. Let's go ahead and take a look at the back of the device now. It does have the sticker pre-installed. Let me go ahead and remove it. Now to the top, bottom, and the side rails, they are made out of metal. And you do have a glass back with 2.5D glass. This color is actually called Breathing Crystal. It's actually a really nice color that it kind of changes as the light reflects off of the glass, and it also has a 4150 milliamp hour non-removable battery. It's actually a really nice design and build to the A5 Pro. Humidigi did a fantastic job. It does have some pretty good weight to it as well, and overall it just looks fantastic in my opinion. I really think this device looks way more expensive than its actual price tag. So next, what I want to do is power on the Humidigi A5 Pro, see if we got some juice, and there we go. Go ahead and remove this pre-installed screen protector with the specifications. There's also a pre-installed screen protector beneath that on the display. As you can see, boot up animation there. So I'm gonna go ahead and go through the setup process, and I'll give you some more hands-on with this device. Okay, so I went through the setup process, but during that I did notice with my pre-installed screen protector that did have some bubbles underneath it, so I'm gonna go ahead and remove it. But if your screen protector doesn't have any bubbles or issues, I would definitely recommend just keeping it on your A5 Pro until you can get a tempered glass. But here we are into the lock screen. Now you got three options to the bottom there. The first one being your voice assistant, the next one being your unlock option, and then you got quick access to your camera. And next I'll go ahead and slide into the home screen. And the first thing I want to talk about here is the display. So it's a very nice looking display. It comes in at 6.3 inches. It's full HD plus. So it is going to be 1080p resolution. Now taking a look at the top of the display there, you got an earpiece, and then beneath the earpiece is going to be the water drop notch cutout. And it actually looks really nice. It's not very large, and to the sides there of the display, they're pretty slim when it comes to the bezels. And then to the bottom there, you got just a little chin there. But overall, this display looks extremely nice. I really like how it looks. And the next thing I want to share with you is if you slide to the side, it does get you into your Google feed. Now mine is not set up. I'm not connected to Wi-Fi. I don't have a SIM card in this device. You also got your Google folder there. And as you can see, all the different Google applications that are available. And then you also got Duo, Settings, you got your Play Store, Dialer, Messaging Application, Chrome, and your camera. Now, when it comes to the A5 Pro, you're pretty much getting a stock Android experience with this device. I mean, there's no bloatware whatsoever, no carrier bloatware. It's just pretty much near stock Android. Now, you also got an option here for the FM radio, which I think is actually pretty fantastic. Plug in a set of headphones to the headphone jack, and then you can be able to listen to FM radio. But as you can see there, this is basically what you get out of the box. And then you also have an option up on top to search for applications. And this is a perfect time to share with you the keyboard. And as you can see, this is running Gboard. It's probably my favorite keyboard on a Android device that you can have. Very customizable, as you can see from a variety of different options that are available with this keyboard. And we also want to share with you the different emojis. At least I'll share with you a couple of the installed emojis here with the Google keyboard. I always share with you this in my unboxing videos. I always try to give you as much information as possible, even to the smallest detail. All right, so that's basically the app drawer. Next, I'll go ahead and go into the status bar, notification panel. Up on top, you got access to your brightness there, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, do not disturb. You got a flashlight option on this as well. You can cast. And then to the other side, you got location, hotspot, additional ones to the bottom there, invert colors, data saver, nightlight, and storage files, as you can see just from a couple of the ones that are available. And jumping into settings now, I'm going to share with you some features that are available, starting with the network and internet. Now going into Wi-Fi, as you can see, this does connect to the 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi, which is pretty fantastic. You also got NFC on board, you got your hotspot and tethering, and then you also got your VPN option. Next, I'll go ahead and jump into battery. So you should get some pretty good battery life out of this. Again, a 4,150 milliamp hour battery. And then moving on from there, going into the buttons. Now, this is actually pretty cool. You got on-screen buttons to the bottom there, but you can actually switch up the directions of your on-screen buttons from your home, your recent apps, to your back button. Not only that, you can also switch up the design, the style, the look of your on-screen buttons, which I think is actually pretty cool. Now, if you decide you don't want to have on-screen buttons, you can actually go with the virtual key, which is basically gestures. So it'll eliminate the on-screen buttons. So basically, you'll swipe up from the center to go home, swipe to the left to go to your recent apps, and then swipe to the far right to go back. So I actually prefer gestures. I'm actually going to leave that on. But let me go ahead and go back into buttons, because you did have another option that was available. So I'm going to go ahead and switch on the hidden navigation bar now. So this is actually a way where you can keep the on-screen buttons, but you can hide them when you feel like it, and then just swipe up when you want the on-screen buttons to appear. So those are actually very good options that are available when it comes to your on-screen buttons. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and go into display now. So with this device here, what's most important is the fact that you have the adaptive brightness, where basically the display will adapt to your lighting conditions. And then next, I'll go ahead and go into storage. So with this device here, you are going to get 32 gigs of internal storage. 6.48 gigabytes is used out of the box, not a whole lot. But if you do need to expand your storage, you can definitely do so on the left-hand side. You got the tray there. And moving on from there, I'll go ahead and jump into security. Now, when it comes to your security features, you got two very important features that are available, one being the fingerprint sensor, and then you have an additional one, which is the facial recognition. Now, it is a little less secure than the fingerprint sensor. There's also a disclaimer there letting you know about that, but I'm going to go ahead and set both of these up. Now, after you're done setting up facial recognition, you also have these additional features that are going to be available, which you can either enable or disable. All right, so I got the fingerprint sensor set up, ready to go. Let's go ahead and test that out now. And as you can see, it unlocked the device. Let's do that once again. There we go. Let me just go ahead and tap on the fingerprint sensor. And wow. All right, so the fingerprint sensor works extremely well. And moving on to the facial recognition, you can see all five of my fingers. And as you can see, the device unlocks. Let me power it off. And then looking at it, it unlocks. So it actually works great. I really don't see any issues. Fingerprint sensor is a little bit faster than facial recognition. But as you can see, they're both very accurate and they both work extremely well. Good features there. All right, next I'll go ahead and go into the accessibility because you do got some additional options. I'll just kind of scroll all the way to the bottom, and as you can see, the different ones that you have available. And moving on from there, you also got May 5th, 2019 security patch. Now, there might be a more current security patch available once I connect to Wi-Fi. And you also got Android 9 Pie on board. So again, the Helio P23 processor, pretty much stock Android Pie and 4 gigs of RAM. I'm liking what I see here so far. Moving on to the camera now. So I want to share with you the camera interface, test out this camera because again, you get a triple camera setup to the back of this device. Now with the main camera, it is a 16 megapixel Sony IMX398 with the f1.8 aperture. You also got the wide angle lens that is available. That's going to be 120 degrees ultra wide angle lens. So as you can see how much more you can fit into the shot when you switch up to that lens. I'll go ahead and switch back to the standard mode. And then as you can see the difference between the two. Now, this is actually pretty interesting. You got the three cameras to the back, 60 megapixel front-facing camera as well. I'll go ahead and go into video recording just for a moment here, just kind of share with you the layout. As you can see, you can take a photo while recording. You can pause and resume recording as well. So let's go ahead and exit out of that and then see what else that you have available. And as you can see, you do get a beauty mode. And then you also get a bokeh mode as well. So basically, the background's going to be blurred out, and then the subject is going to be in focus. And then when it comes to the left-hand side, as you can see, you got additional options there. For instance, you have the option for HDR that is available. You can have that on or off, and as well as the flash. And then you also got that wide-angle lens to the rear-facing camera. Let's go ahead and take a look at settings now and see some of the options you have available. Now, when it comes to the screen modes, click on that and take a look at all the options that are available. I mean, there's so many different screen modes to choose from. It's pretty insane. I'm just gonna go ahead and click on auto and leave it at that. But as you can see, you got the anti-shake, you got the self-timer, you can adjust the picture size, zero shutter delay. When it comes to the video recording settings, you got the microphone option, and the highest quality you can record in is going to be full HD resolution. So that's going to be 1080p. Again, this was just a quick look at the camera interface. I'll cover more in the full review. Well, that's pretty much it for my unboxing and hands-on of the Yumidigi A5 Pro. Again, this is a $130 device. Fully unlocked for all GSM carriers. You can pick it up off of Amazon. So far, I'm really liking what I'm seeing here out of the box. I think you're getting some great value with this really nice 1080p display. You got the triple cameras on this, large 4,150 milliamp hour battery, 4 gigs of RAM, NFC. I think the only thing that is lacking on this device is the Type-C charging. It's kind of unfortunate they went with micro USB, but I mean, there's always some trade-offs, but either way, you're getting a good amount of value here, especially when it comes to the build quality as well. Metal frame, glass back panel, this breathing crystal color looks really nice when the light does reflect off of it. And again, case included, a screen protector pre-installed, so I really like what Yumadigi is bringing to the table. I'll definitely let you know how this device works out for me in a full review in a couple weeks. But once again, everybody, I thank you for taking the time to watch this unboxing video. If you enjoyed it, please hit the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to the channel for more future videos. This is Paul Tech, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.